My name is Jessica Miriam. My topic today is inclusion, and my audience is school board members and family. Today I am focusing on the importance of inclusion. I'm part of that because I had to go through that in my life too. I am an individual with a developmental disability, and besides training to become an advocate for Partners Grants, I am also a global messenger for the Special Olympics. I had the pleasure of meeting Tim Schreiber, who is the CEO of Special Olympics. He's also the son of Eunice Kennedy Schreiber, who founded Special Olympics. So he inspired me to be an advocate. It is important to know what your gifts and talents are rather than any disabilities you may have. I picked this topic because I know what it's like to be both included and excluded in different situations. I am connected to this issue because I always wanted to try new and challenging activities. It didn't always work out, and I didn't always fit in, but in the end, I always felt better about myself for doing my best and know that I can do anything I can do. Inclusion is also very important because disabled people need to be given a chance to meet new people, make friends, and contribute to society. Inclusion isn't just for school kids anymore, and never really was. Relationship circles are important. There are four sections in this circle: intimacy, friendship, participation, and exchange. The average person's circle is full, as opposed to the person with a disability, whose circle is empty in two of the sections, participation and friendship. This creates loneliness and isolation. This can be changed by connecting people with common interests. They will recognize each other's similar values, strengths, and even challenges. Inclusion is about everyone. People should not be cut short simply because they have disabilities. They should be given the same opportunities to contribute to our society as everyone else. I would like to thank my audience again for hearing my testimony. So I leave with a quote from enablekids.ca. Let's start talking, but without the word disabled in our vocabularies. If you have any questions about this issue, please don't be afraid to contact me. Thanks.